says. The makers of the all-new
All night in the Iowa Cafe. Friday night and the farm boys with their pay. Fine bodies and clean faces. All of them proud to be drunk. No meanness, just energy. At the next table, they talked cars for hours. Friends coming and going. Hollering over, the one with a heavy face and pale hair kept talking about the Chevy he had years ago and how it could take everything in a second, moaning that he should never have sold it. Didn't he show old Hank? Bet your ass. That 4th of July when Schlevedine got too much patriotism and beer and gave some to everybody down by the river. Hank's so mad because I left him like he was standing still. Best car that ever was, and never should have let it go. Tears falling on his eggs. Little Boy by B.H. Fairchild. The sun lowers on our backyard in Kansas. And I am looking up through the circling spokes of a bicycle, asking my father as mindlessly as I would ask if he ever saw DiMaggio or Mantle why we dropped the bomb on those two towns in Japan. And his face goes all wooden, the eyes freezing like rabbits in headlights, the palm of his hand slowly tapping the arm of the lawn chair that has appeared in family photographs since 1945. The shadow of my mother thrown across it. The green Packard in the background, which my father said he bought because after Saipan and Tinian and Okinawa, I felt like they owed it to me. These were names I didn't know. Islands distant as planets, anonymous. Where is Saipan? Where is Okinawa? Where is the Pacific? Could you see the cloud in the air? Like the smoke from Eugene Messenbaum's semi. That huge cloud when he rolled it out on Highway 54 last winter. The hand is hammering the chair arm, beating it, and I know it's all wrong. As I move backward on the garage floor and watch his eyes watching the sun in his evening burial and the spreading silver light and then darkness over the farms and vast flat fields, which I will grow so tired of, so weary of years later, that I will leave. Watching then, as I do now, his eyes, as they take in the falling rag of the sun, a level stare, a gaze that asks nothing and gives nothing. The sun burning itself to ashes constantly, the orange maze blackening in drought and waste, and he can do nothing, and neither can I.